What bar District 87 is takes substance abuse and our efforts partnering with you as parents and preventing substance abuse seriously. Throughout the year, we have preseason meetings for our athletic teams. We have components in our health class. We have Live Life Well Week. We give a comprehensive Illinois youth survey. It gives us data. Each high school has parent groups that are actively involved, partnering with the high school. And of course, we have the GPS series, which many of the speakers speak to this topic. This year, some of you may know, we have taken quite a bit of time to review our athletic code, actually extracurricular code. All the variety of activities students participate in, they have to hold a standard of behavior to participate. And in the code of conduct, the student handbook that you received at the beginning of the year, that's probably on the shelf at home, there are 37 different offenses, ranging from theft, trespassing, gambling, academic dishonesty. And when students occasionally make bad choices, parents understand, kids understand, they learn from this experience. One of the code violations is alcohol, and it's interesting how that violation gets a variety of feedback that often is resistant. This past year, we had a couple of big alcohol parties, underage drinking occurred. We worked in partnership with the local public safety and had to process dozens of students that were athletes. And when you go through that, you get to take a good look at different perspectives of parents' view of alcohol and when kids should be allowed to begin to drink, when can kids be around others that are drinking. But at Glenbar, we take it very, very seriously. We know students at this age are susceptible to risky behavior. We know how much peer influence is involved. And so we work very hard at partnering with you as parents and holding a standard, not only through our discipline, but through education. So thank you for partnering with us on that. And again, thank you so much to GPS that provides these excellent programs. Turn it over to Gil.
I agree with Dr. Larson, it's a beautiful night, and I'm so glad those of you that made it here are here tonight. A couple of people to introduce. Antoine Anderson was just here adjusting the lights. Thank you. He's Assistant Principal of Student Services here at Glenbar East. Peg Manning, raise your hand. Everybody knows your name. Now they get to see you're the person sending out all those emails to everybody. Thank you so much. That's great. Our moderator this evening, I'm very happy, is Linda Lewaniak. Linda Lewaniak is the director of the Center for Addictions Medicine. She's a social worker. She's the Center for Addictions Medicine at Alexian Brothers Hospital is where she works and thrives. She'll serve as moderator and introduce our panel. And again, thank you to all of you for coming tonight.
We're going to start out with Detective Bruce Talbot. He is dedicated to sharing information on illegal street drugs, synthetic designer drugs, over-the-counter drug use, and other underage alcohol use. Detective Talbot was named Police Officer of the Year by the Illinois Crime Commission in 2000. He was called as an expert witness before the U.S. Senate committee and is published an author of both a popular press and scientific publications. Please welcome Bruce Talbot.
That was a long time ago. What's he done since then? I don't have a clicker. So, I have a human clicker. Let's go to the first slide. I want to try and stop the hysteria. We seem to be a hysterical-driven society, always waiting for the next big thing. How many have you heard of Crocodile? It was on 2, 5, 7, and 9. I don't know if 11 made it or not. When they broadcast that, my phone ran off the hook. Everybody wanted to get so excited about this new designer Russian synthetic heroin called Crocodile. 6 cases reported in the Chicago metropolitan area. Doctor on camera talking about how devastating this new designer synthetic drug is. Let's get to some facts. Number one, of those 6 cases, how many were really Russian designer synthetic heroin called Crocodile? 0. None of them. It's all fake. Well, the doctor says the doctor was wrong. Doctors make mistakes. They get things wrong. What we were looking at is what you see in this picture. It's called wound botulism. They're sharing dirty needles and they're shooting contaminated heroin. They get sores, and all of a sudden we're talking about Russian heroin. Now, is there such a thing as a new designer synthetic Russian heroin called Crocodile? Yes, it is a terrible problem in Russia. Could we have it here? Yes, as soon as the news media broadcast it, we had a case. Somebody saw it, went on YouTube, figured out how to make it, made it, and immediately got sick. Thank you, news media. What you need to know as a parent is not to get so focused on what's new, dangerous, and get sucked in to that media hype. Our big problem here is not a new designer synthetic narcotic. Our big problem isn't even heroin, and you're probably saying, how can he say that? Everybody that gets on stage makes a speech about, we have a heroin epidemic in our community. I'm here to tell you, you don't. We have a Vicodin epidemic in our community. We are losing more people to Vicodin, more addictions to Vicodin. We're arresting more people with Vicodin, hydrocodone, than we are any other narcotic. That is our problem here. Not something new. Stop getting excited about that. Have you heard in the news media, the newest is Flocka. New designer synthetic drug. It's sweeping the country. Some places they call it gravel. It's the most addictive drug. It's the worst. You overdose, it drives you crazy, makes you a zombie. There's a picture of it. Does it exist? Yes. Do I want you focused and crazy about this? No. Our big problem is Vicodin. Keep your eye on where the problem is. Don't get distracted by the media. Flocka is just another designer synthetic bath salt. There's 38 of them out there. It's just the media selling newspapers. Next slide. What is real? That's real. When we hear in the media about another student who overdoses and dies on bad heroin, I'm here to tell you it's not bad heroin. It's really, really, really good heroin. So good that they're overdosing and dying on it. But it's not the heroin that's killing them. It's a drug called fentanyl. Fentanyl that we use in hospitals is roughly 80 times more potent than morphine. There are 12 different designer drug analogs of fentanyl. One of them is 100 times more potent than morphine. And the drug dealers, the gangs, will add fentanyl to the street heroin so it's better stuff. The buyers are always looking for better stuff, a more intense high. And the only way to make heroin better or more intense or stronger is to add fentanyl. And that's what's killing people. Now, having said that, are most people dying from a narcotic pure overdose? And the truth is no. Most of the folks who die from a narcotic overdose stop breathing. That's what's killing folks. And I had a chance to talk to your school resource officer here, and one of the questions I asked is, do you have Narcan kits here? And he says, yes, we do. We've got trained on it, we're ready. Glad to hear that. Glen Bard East is aware and in front of this problem and taking action. Next slide for me. I was asked to speak about drug trends. What's the drug trend? Well, I already tipped my hand, didn't I? Narcotics. Here's what we're seeing in DuPage County. This is the most recent data we have from the Illinois State Police Lab. I write their drug trends report for them every quarter. And what we're seeing is primarily heroin, and that's been going up. Cocaine is number two, and that's been consistently dropping. And methamphetamine is a tiny little blip on the radar screen, especially up here. Having said that, what you need to know as parents is all drugs go through wave cycles of popularity. And we happen to be in a wave of narcotics abuse and a trough of cocaine. Folks, when I started my career back in the 70s, the number one drug was cocaine. It was not heroin. This will change. Heroin will become unpopular, it will fall off, cocaine will come back, all drugs go through these cycles. You just need to know that that what you're seeing there is going to change. It always does. Next slide. I told you not to focus so much on heroin, to focus on Vicodin. Here's the most recent data we have. There are two drugs that you as a parent should be aware of. Vicodin, hydrocodone. It also goes by the name Norco and Lortab. It's all the same stuff, just different manufacturer's name. And the second drug that you need to be aware of is Xanax. The kids call them Z-bars. The most common drug abuse is poly-prescription drug abuse. Polypharming is what we call it. They will take a narcotic like Vicodin, they will multiply the synergistic effects, the intoxicating effects, by adding a depressant, Xanax, to it. One and one doesn't equal two, it has a synergistic multiplying effect, one and one equals 11. Both of these drugs, a narcotic and a depressant, suppress respiration rates. And that's what's primarily killing folks. If you are the parent of an at-risk youth, you know they're using. You should have Narcan in your home and be monitoring them and be ready to administer that. Next slide. Narcan is an absolute miracle drug, and I am so proud to have been a DuPage officer. DuPage is the first county in the entire United States to equip every uniformed police officer with Narcan. Why? We're the first on the scene. When we find someone who is polydrugging Vicodin and Xanax, or they're doing heroin and they've stopped breathing, we have just a few precious minutes to save their lives. We take the syringe out, there is no needle. We put a foam cup on the end of the syringe, it goes up a nostril. You spray half of the syringe in one nostril, the other half in the other, and within 1 minute, the drug pushes out the narcotic from the brain receptor cells, they open their eyes, and they breathe. Folks, in the first 6 months of this program, we have saved 22 lives. This should be in every school. You know, when I come to a school and I walk down the hallway, I see the defibrillators hanging on the wall. And given my age, I'm happy to see them. We should have Narcan in every school, just like we have a defibrillator in every school. There is absolutely no way that you can hurt somebody with this. All you can do is save a life. Next slide for me, please. I want to try to put things into perspective. Show of hands. How many people think it's gotten worse with drugs? Most. How many think it's gotten better? Stop watching the damn TV. Stop falling for the hype on TV. It's getting better. When I started as a cop, it was worse with substance abuse in the 70s than it is now. It's not worse. Let me close by talking about what's going on with pot. Everybody's asking about it, especially now that we have medical marijuana in Illinois. What we are seeing with pot is what I like to call a cognitive dissonance. The judge and I were talking about this beforehand. No matter what science you put forward, no matter what facts you put forward, kids can't internalize it because it's just weed. It's not a bad drug. And in fact, the scientific research shows the opposite. So why won't kids get that message? Why don't kids view cannabis as a drug instead of it's just weed? And the reason is, my opinion and the opinion of others, medical marijuana. How can you on the one hand say this is a medicine that's helping sick people, and on the other hand say it's a bad drug, you shouldn't do it, kids? That's what we mean by cognitive dissonance. The two messages are fighting each other. So what we're seeing in the environment right now is an increase in adolescent marijuana use. And what's most disturbing to me is not the experimenters. What's most disturbing to me is what you see in this graphic. This is brand new data. It's just a few months old. This is daily marijuana smoking, age 12 and up. Daily. Folks, if you're doing anything, whether it's drinking or anything, and you're getting high on that substance daily, you have an addiction. Well, excuse me, you can't get addicted to pot. Yes, you can. And they need to hear that from you. When we look at what is the best anti-drug message out there, it's you. When you sit and talk to your child passionately and make a moral statement about substance abuse, 42% lower substance abuse risk. When you sit down and talk to your child and make a moralistic statement, please do that. Next slide. There's a couple other things that you should be aware of. Number one, pot has changed dramatically. This wasn't around when I was on the street. This is a new form of hashish, which is 80 times more potent than the THC in pot. They're using vape pens for that. I happened to be getting some exercise at the Fox Valley Mall, and I saw a student, I don't know if you can see this on the slide, electronic cigarettes, illegal as of 2014. Next slide. I'm at the Fox Valley Mall and I see a young person buying a vape pen. Can you see his sweatshirt? What does it say? National Honor Society. And he's buying a vape pen so that he can do dabs. It's stop stereotyping people. It's not the bad kid. It's not somebody else's kid. It's even National Honor Society kids. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed the other presenters.